Deathbringer is the new Void rocket launcher in Shadowkeep, and it's like you stuffed a Slova Bomb Nova Bomb inside a rocket launcher. This thing is fantastic for doing multiple target DPS as well as single target DPS, especially if there's a Void burn. It will track its target very aggressively, making it an interesting tool in PvP, and it overall kicks butt. So how do you get it? You're going to start your mission at Eris Morn. Now, I've already completed this quest, so the reward is shown differently, but Lunar Spelunker is the first step in your mission, where you need to complete three different lost sectors. The first one we completed is an archer's line to the left of my character there. Make your way to the back left corner of the map, and you're going to find a lost sector inside the building. Now, you're going to just play your way through this and complete it. Nothing special here, no tricks, no gimmicks, just get your butt in there. There will be multiple nightmare enemies that spawn, as well as a few additional enemies like captains, but for the most part, it's just kill the servitor, get the code, the cache code, and open it up to complete it. You won't get anything rare to drop, but it'll be completion towards the quest. As for the next lost sector, it's kind of across from the Hellmouth in this back little area. Pretty damn hard to miss. Just look at your map, look for the icon, and follow it. It's like literally impossible to miss. Once again, slay the enemies, nothing special here, and make your way to the third one. This lost sector is in the Anchor of Light in this large building that, if you played Destiny 1, you probably spent a lot of time farming helium filaments. Make your way through the building, go down below, and once you get to the end, slay out enemies until the alarm goes off and the final boss is summoned. Kill the boss, clear out any other enemies you might want to, and open the chest. Now, you're not going to get the next piece of the puzzle instantly. You actually have to go into your bounties, go to Lunar Spelunker, and retrieve it. It will give you the next piece that will allow you to continue the quest line. Once you're ready, go to Sorrow's Harbor and go to the Lost Sector here. Now, after doing this Lost Sector, if you look over to the right here, there is a jump up, there is a hole in the wall. Make your way through here, and there's going to be a door. Luckily, you have the key from that last quest, and you're going to be able to input it and unlock this door. Inside is a broken necklace that you'll need to recharge in order to take to Eris Morn and continue the quest line. In order to get the necklace scraps needed to complete this, you need to get arc kills on nightmares. Now, it has to be on the moon as well, so you can't go to any other areas, so the best area for this is probably our good friend Sorrow's Harbor. You're gonna be here quite a bit. Weaken enemies with your guns and then use arc abilities to finish them off. I highly recommend if you're trying to use your grenades, you make sure they're very weak because they're yellow health bar enemies and sometimes they kind of trick you with how weak they are. Same with your melee. Make sure they're very weak and pop that melee. But sometimes there's gonna be a lot of people in the area competing for these nightmares and it can be frustrating. Unfortunately, if you're in a team, you can't share the kills. It has to be your kill. It has to be your arc ability that hits it and kills it for the final blow. If your teammate shoots it, they don't get any sort of progress, so you're gonna have to do this solo or just kind of spread out and not steal each other's kills. You can help shoot the enemies together and then use your abilities to kill them, and if you work as a team, it'll go pretty damn fast. Hopefully there's no other people in this part of the mission, and the more AoE you have, the better. Stormcaller's great, Arcstaff is great, the Titan's great, but if you want to do this optimally, just make sure you're not using abilities on a full health bar enemies like I just did there. I could have gotten both of those weaken and gotten two kills. That was lazy. Don't be like me. Make sure that every time you have an ability up, the enemy is weak before you pop it. Once you're all charged up, you can head to this portal where Eris normally stands and go and see her. You're going to give her the necklace and continue the rest of the mission here. And as a little bonus treat, you get a kinetic sniper that is a powerful drop. Now, the next part of the mission is actually underground. One of the fastest ways to get to the Circle of Bones is through Archer's Line and to the big door from one of the first moon missions, We've Awoken the Hive. As long as you make your way underground into the caves, you'll find this pretty damn easily. I don't want to spoil every last minute and inch of this thing, but you're going to make your way to Fogoth's Arena, kill all the enemies inside, and get the next piece of the quest. The Silent Skull that you collect will turn into the Tainted Lullaby, which is going to be an exotic quest for you to start. Head over to Eris Morn and get this underway. You're going to need 3 pieces of bone. You're going to need some bone marrow, some ritualistic bone, and a festering bone. They're pretty easy to get. You get 1 from the Hellmouth public event, which is a witch summoning. Very easy to do. Complete the witch summoning, get this piece. The next bone you're going to get from a lost sector, the one with the crystals. Again, very easy to do. Just play through the lost sector and you're going to get it. Then the final one is from the Bone Collector. Now this is a random acolyte that spawns very rapidly. We were able to find multiple every few minutes in the Anchor of Light. If you need a refresher, Sorrow's Harbor has the Lost Sector that you need. Just complete it and make sure to open the chest so that you get your bone. Head to the Hellmouth when there's a public event, kill the boss, and it should drop as the public event ends. And you're gonna notice that I'm getting the exotic next piece of the quest. That's because I did it in a different order. You won't get this if this is the second thing you do. As for the Bone Collector, it is literally just a random acolyte. He spawns in the middle of Anchor of Light, roams around, walks around. He's kind of quick, but there's lots of them that spawn like literally a minute or two apart. We were able to kill it multiple times because some people missed it, so don't stress over this one. After that, you need to do the Scarlet Keep Strike. Now, you need to kill the High Conductor, and we found this enemy on the elevator sequence. But we think that you have to actually drop down below and kill these wizards to spawn it. We had some people asking us where the hell we found it, and we don't know if you're supposed to drop down, but we dropped down, we saw a bunch of wizards, we think that's how you spawn it. You can see in the footage here, we kill these wizards, there's one behind the thing here, and then it spawns later, so just do it, don't gamble on it, make sure you kill it. Now, the boss might spawn up here like it did normally every single time, but we didn't want to risk it. I don't want you to risk it, because then you got to play through the whole damn thing over again. Just do it. It takes a couple seconds. Kill those wizards, and then the next piece is going to be in your hands. Now, I recommend finishing up that Scarlet Keep mission, because you'll actually get a little bit of progress for Symphony of Death. You need to get red health bar enemy kills, yellow health bar enemy kills or major kills, as well as boss kills or guardians in the crucible, whatever you feel more comfortable. However, it is very easy to do this if you use this one little tip. Head back over to Sorrow's Harbor, where we've been about 10 different times, and kill the nightmares that spawn there. The yellow health bar acolytes and thralls count as major kills, and the ogre counts as a boss every single time, giving you 10%. Now, you get a bonus being on the moon, and you can complete this anywhere, but why wouldn't you just complete it here? You just have to kill a few ogres, boom, 100%. Kill a bunch of the majors, and you're going to get some major progress, and it actually took us longer to kill the red health bar enemies. Make sure to tag everyone you see, hit everything with supers and grenades, just make sure you're getting progress on this, but you'll probably have to do some public events as well as lost sectors to complete it, because we finished the bosses way, way earlier than anything else. Unless you're tagging the enemies, it doesn't appear like you share progress, so you might want to split up here, but I can't be sure. Sometimes it felt like we were getting progress, sometimes it didn't. I don't know if it's proximity-based, but just kill everything in your path. You'll get this done in just a few minutes. Well, maybe 10 or 15 minutes, but you'll get it done pretty darn quick. Now, the next part of this quest is a pretty tough mission at 920 power level. If you can bring some friends, you might want to, and if you're looking at the map marker there, that is again under the ground. You're going to need to find an entrance in Archer's Line, and there's a couple other ones around the map, and make your way down to the dark area at the bottom of the well, if you want to call it that. Once you're underground, it's pretty easy to find. Just make your way down there and you'll find the quest marker, no problem. Now, there's gonna be a lot of drama here, okay? These enemies hit pretty hard. Use exotics, use heavy, use your supers. If you need a well of radiance to stay alive, do it. Slay out all the enemies. If you got area of effect like a storm caller, it can be very good because there are quite a few trash mobs in the area and some ogre that will spawn that can be pretty lethal as well. But honestly, if you have a good team, you can kind of burst down the boss and you don't have to stress out too much, but just don't stand out in the open like an idiot, like I did. Kill the enemies, get the final piece, and make your way to Eris Morn. She's gonna give you the Deathbringer. It's a powerful, heavy slot drop. It is an amazing rocket launcher, and you're going to love it. I'm telling you, it is awesome in PvE for single target, for area of effect on multiple targets. I love it. And it's even kind of trolly in PvE. Now, you only get one. You only get one shot in PvP, but it's kind of fun. I'll show you a couple little clips at the end here. But that's pretty much it for me, though, guys. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed. And make sure to share this with your friends. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
This arc and the battle is yours. Down. Zone A lost. Fire team that fights together.